100% of what I'm going to.
But you gotta win at the track at 61 kilos.
It gets tougher every day to keep it down.
Then you gotta stay on your feet and fight it.
You stay on your feet and fight it. I'll fight it from right here on my tail. Come on. Sit down and enjoy the sights. Look at that church over there. Pretty as a postcard, huh?
Uh-huh.
Where can you see anything like that?
Maybe in America.
Huh?
What does it look like?
Well, like it looks like here in Murano, Italy. Well, I guess with the horse track down there in the mountains, I guess it does look a little like Santa Anita in California.
I've seen it in books. They got everything in the States.
Dry up, Joe.
It said...
Dry up.
Why is it whenever I try to talk to you...
Come on.
Dry up, dry up.
We'll cool off walking back to the funicular, huh?
You better run.
Tight as a drum.
Yeah?
You got your doubts?
With everything?
Everything.
Maybe we run?
Hey. Okay, lead off.
Ciao, fortuna, eh? Grazie.
Kid, if you're getting tired of chasing around, we could settle here.
If we could go back...
Well, we could settle here, for instance, and get us a house and hire a woman to do the cooking. How about it?
Anything you say, Bob.
Of course, we'd have to get us a nest egg first.
Which ain't easy.
Well, you never can tell. We may be able to get off the merry-go-round before you know it. Good idea, huh?
Yeah, Pop. Do you know if the track looked pretty from here?
Ah, che bella corsa. Magnifica. Dan the butler tenti di vincere la corsa.
It sure looks like it.
You want him to look like he's trying to lose? Everybody's not as stupid as you. I bought him to lose, he'll manage to lose.
You don't act so bought right now.
You'll lose.
Now we have to fall off the horse.
Al chiostro, al chiostro. Zone farà butto, canaglia. Guardi che cosa ci hai combinato.
Shut up.
Never throw away good tickets.
These?
These. They'll be good.
Say, Pop, you know what it was like when you was coming off the stretch?
Like what, kid?
Like pulling the cork out of a bottle of Chianti.
Pianola, kid. This course rides itself.
Double frosser.
by that.
Hare, kid, hare.
Pesos 60 kilos.
Skip out and get us a cab. I'll be dressed in 5 minutes.
Okay.
With the French visas. The visas!
Sì, l'americano.
Che ti piglia un accidente. Non sai che cosa significa vista consolare? Presto! Presto!
My. Of all the luck. 3 more days and Americans won't need visas.
We got 3 days, ain't we? What's the hurry?
Well, I'm sick of it here, kid.
But just this morning you were talking about settling down.
Well, that was this morning. Now I got a hankering to see Paris again, ride some real horses.
Is that where we're going this time? To Paris?
Well, they got the best tracks in the world up there. Any objections?
No, Papa, me.
La carrozza è qui?
Sì, signore.
El bagaglio. El conto e passaporto.
Sarà servito.
Only what? Come on, spit it out.
Only back home in America, I hear they have swell tracks, too.
That again, Joe. I'm surprised at you falling for that stuff. America, flat tracks, dirt tracks. And the life there, it's on the fritz, believe me. Here we go where we please and see the sights. Call the porter, quick. Tell him to bring the bags back.
What's the matter, Pop?
Oh, never mind. Now, look, Joe. We're gonna have some fun. I want you to slip over the roofs and down. You know the way you do when you're playing with the kids?
Yeah.
Run for the station and grab the tickets for Paris. You think you can handle that?
You're pulling my leg.
Am I? Now, look. You see Bork down there?
Yeah.
Well, he's coming up. You know, he's been pestering me about going into business with him, and in a weak moment, I said yes. Now, I don't like the smell of it.
I see.
He knows I want a big bet on myself, and he wants a piece, which he's not gonna get. See, so I'll stick around here and kid him along, wait for the visas, then I'll meet you at the station, right?
Right.
Okay.
But, Pop, you don't think...
Have I ever lied to you, kid?
Of course not.
Now, stop your yakking and get going.
It's only yakking because I'll miss the fun with Bork.
Yak, yak, yak all night and you'll miss the train. Go on. The police. La questura. Presto.
E Dan Butler, sopra.
Stanza numero 12.
Sì. Sì, l'americano. Fatto presto. Who is it?
Io. Just who are you expecting?
Well, it's about time you got here. Where's the rest of my money? You know, we made a deal, didn't we? 10,000 lira before the race, 10 after. Where's the other 10?
Get boss, lightning boss. Just how much did you bet on yourself today, smart boy?
I don't bet him, Bork. I ride him.
Tell that to the stewards.
Exactly. In the stretch, they had me covered like a blanket with their glasses. I try to give the race away all the way. Is it my fault your boy wouldn't take it? I did my job.
You could have fall off.
Are you telling me how to ride? I'm not risking my neck or my license for a measly 20 grand in liras. Now, Louie, let's have the rest of the dough. Come on.
I lost 3 million lira. There's much more with the books.
Well, there are 100 different ways a deal can go sour. You can get your money back. That wasn't the last horse race in the world. You set something up and make sure it don't go wrong. I'm not going anywhere.
No?
No. Where would I be going without the kid?
I'd hate to think I'd been double-crossed, especially by a tin-horn crook. That would hurt my pride.
All right, if you feel that way about it, tomorrow when the bank opens, I'll pay you off. What I can, and the rest I'll make up to you.
First, you were demanding the rest of your dough. Now you're in a hurry to pay me back. Search him. Mr. Butler's tied up right now. Yeah, I'll take a message. The desk clerk downstairs. Good. He says your bill is ready.
I'm changing hotels. Bed bugs.
Fine. Good. said your visas have come.
Get him. You'll miss some fun. There she is, kid. Paris, the sweetheart of the world.
I had my stable trunk shipped here. I got a pal that...
Hey!
What's the matter, Pop?
Don't look the same. It's the right corner, though. It's gotta be.
I thought we were going to the horses.
I had my stuff shipped to my best pal, Claude. He runs the place. I figured he'd do okay, but I never expected a deal like this. I think we sent our tack to the right spot, all right. Hey, garçon.
Sure.
Where's the boss?
Pardon?
Le patron. Je suis Dan Butler, un ami.
Ah, le patron, il est en bas dans la petite boîte.
Merci. He's got a nightclub, too. Sit down.
Where are you going, Paul?
Cool your brain with a lemonade. I'll be right back.
Regardez bien. Regardez bien. Regardez bien. Oh, c'est ça.
Où est la patronne? Le patron, Claude.
Monsieur Claude?
Continuez sans moi. Claude isn't here.
No? Well, I'm an old pal of his. Just blew into town.
I know who you are. I know all about you.
Yeah?
Yes. Now get out.
What?
I've been waiting a long time to say that.
You've been waiting? Listen, I just came to...
Your trunks came this morning. I sent them back.
You sent all my stuff back?
Your baggage is no more welcome than you are.
Listen, lady, I don't know who you are, and I don't care. I don't like strangers shipping my trunks around. I got my tack in them. How do you expect me to get work?
That's your worry.
Maybe the express company still has them. If not, follow them back to Italy.
Listen, nobody's throwing me out anywhere. Who are you anyway? Where's Claude?
Get out. Ou je vous fais flanquer dehors.
Hey! I never saw that dame before. Who is she? Where's Claude?
Je comprends pas un mot d'anglais.
Écoutez. Ah, forget it. If anything happens to my stuff, there'll be French chicken feathers scattered all over this joint.
Madame, qu'est-ce que je dois faire avec le gosse?
Quel gosse?
Ben, le petit Américain. Le fils de Dan Butler. Il l'a laissé ici cet après-midi.
Je ne savais pas qu'il avait un fils. Après tout, c'est son affaire, pas la mienne. Henri.
Oui?
Continue ce que tu faisais, je vais m'occuper du petit.
Bien, madame.
I thought you was Pop when you shipped me.
Dan Butler's your father?
Yes, ma'am.
You've been here all afternoon?
I don't mind, ma'am. Lots of times Pop gets tied up in important business. I guess you'd like me to pay up and move along. Only Pop's got the bankroll and he...
I know.
Sure is a long jiffy.
I suppose you're hungry.
Not very, ma'am.
Tell the truth.
Yes, ma'am.
There's a cure for that. Come upstairs.
I'd better sit here like he said.
He won't mind.
Are you a friend of Pop's?
Yes, we're great friends. Come along. Nous allons avoir une bonne petite conversation tous les deux.
Hmm? Huh? Yes, ma'am.
Someday you won't object so much when a lady will ask you to her apartment. Si Monsieur Butler demande après son fils, il est chez moi.
Oui, madame.
Il y a seulement trois étages. Quand on est jeune, ça n'a pas l'importance.
I only hope Pop hasn't gone and got himself lost.
Believe me when I tell you, your father knows his way around.
Well, that's the way it goes, ma'am. The merry-go-round, Pop calls it.
Why did he get out of Italy so fast?
He just got the itch again.
But why did he come back here?
You sure are full of questions, ma'am.
I'm his friend. It's nice to know what your friends have been doing.
He said his friend was some guy named Claude.
Oh. And besides, you Americans are very strange. A big country of your own, but always going round and round.
Do you know anything about America, ma'am?
Me? A lot. The G.I. Joes. They were around for quite a while.
Would you tell me what you know, ma'am?
I only have a one-sided view of America. I doubt if you'd be interested.
Fair is fair, ma'am. I let you pump me.
Well, the way I got it, America is a great big country which is entirely populated by men who are misunderstood. No, not entirely.
Huh?
There are also the women who misunderstand them. If it isn't the wife, it is a girl who is out sitting under the apple tree.
What apple tree?
The good old apple tree. A lot of things must grow on trees. Cigarettes and chocolate bars. Nylon stockings. Anything.
I don't get you, ma'am.
What?
Getting taken in like that. You ought to be ashamed. You sure got took in.
Well, I did I?
You sure did, swallowing that. Why, America's wonderful. Anybody knows that. Apple trees. Well, you're as bad as Pop. I keep trying to tell my Pop that anything he wants, right there. Yeah, and the swellest racetracks, too.
Then why did you ask me?
Nothing.
You know so much. Just like your father. Always looking for a chance to put out your chest and make a speech.
Nothing, ma'am.
Then why?
Why did you ask me?
Because I ain't never seen it, ma'am.
Never?
Not to remember. I just asked guys about it. Read some.
Sit down, kid, and finish your dinner.
I'm full.
Just hungry for America.
Well, don't you like being a Frenchman, ma'am?
Yeah. Sit down, kid. It's a very good meal for you.
The cake? You sure got funny names for things here.
Anything's funny until you understand it. Your mother's American?
Sure, until she died. But I got some relatives. Would you like to see their pictures?
I wouldn't mind.
I don't know what she died of. Papa only says she got sick of chasing after the horses. Here. That's my Aunt Esther and my cousin servant Bill. Uncle Ned's taking the picture.
Don't pay attention to what I said about America. It's a fine place for a boy.
Okay. They live on a farm in Michigan. That's where Pop met Mom when he was down on his luck and riding on a hit track. They keep inviting us.
And why don't you go?
Pop? Don't ever ask him. And don't tell him how I shut off about it. Don't get me wrong. He's a great guy, but he's kind of funny about this. You won't, will you, ma'am?
It's a promise. And stop calling me ma'am. I've got a name. My name is Paul.
Now you are kidding me. Paul's a guy's name.
You have Paul or Polly. Can't we have Paul?
Polly, that makes sense. My name's Joe. Not G.I. Joe. Just plain Joe.
I've got to go down to work, but make my place your own. I guess you're a pretty good boy. I wish you luck, plain Joe.
Voulez-vous garder mon auto?
Oui, monsieur.
Merci.
Alors, ma jeune, regarde pas mes roses.
Danger dans la nuit. Quand un murmure fou de désir, ta raison ignore. Your overrated.
Kids in my apartment. Wes Hunger, I fed him.
Oh, thanks. That was nice of him.
It's a shame he hasn't a father to take care of him.
Oh, Joe's doing okay. He's smart as a whip. I got some good news for you. My trunks have to be sent back here, whether you like it or not. Listen, do me a favor, will you? Sit down and tell me what you've got against me.
Could take all night.
Good. Take all night.
Now, I've got news for you. Once, I admired you. Call it hero worship.
No kidding.
I love the horses and the excitement, and you were, as Joe said, the great jockey.
Oh, Joe's prejudiced.
One day at the track, you fell at the water jump, right in front of the stands. Then you got up again and tried to win. People yelled and screamed, and I yelled. I think I even cried. I know I went around outside the jockey's room to get a look at you.
I bet I didn't tell you to get out.
You didn't even see me. You passed me on to Claude.
Oh, well, that was very nice of me.
Wasn't it? I was a kid. Many thanks.
Well, maybe now that I'm back, Claude will return the favor. He's quite a guy. Always asking me for tips. Cigarette?
No. Which you sold him good or bad?
He sold back to some sucker for a rosy profit. I did him plenty of favors.
You certainly did. Everything he had was yours. Everything you told him he'd do. That was you and Claude when I started going around with him. You put him in the right crowd and sold him the right tip. And then you pulled out at the right moment. Back to America, wasn't it? Where you met that girl at that hick track. But Claude had no place to run. Claude is dead.
Claude, dead? When?
What difference does it make? They killed him for what you got him into.
Look, when you talk to me like that, listen to my answer.
Why?
Where do you get this I killed Claude stuff? A guy plays for big dough, there's big risks. It's the breaks, the odds, the chances he takes. You too. You were so in love with this guy, you gotta blame someone?
Go get your boy and get out.
You're a pretty cold dame.
You bet I am.
I enjoy cold dames.
Oh, fais attention, mon petit, ne te laisse pas aller.
T'occupe pas.
Who's the monkey in the cage?
The monkey in the cage is Henriette, my sister.
C'est toujours la même histoire avec moi. Commencement, ça laisse-moi donc tranquille. Je suis assez grand pour savoir ce que j'ai à faire. Et puis après, des larmes. Et toujours, oh, si j'avais su, si
ça... Mets-toi de ce qui te regarde.
It was a little too rapid for me. What'd she say?
She's reminding me about myself. That all my life I had to do with stinkers. I don't know why. But if there is a real no-good heel around, I sooner or later end up with him. So get your kid and get out.
Oh, you'll end up with me?
There he is.
Miss Polly, I want to sleep on your couch.
We go, kid. We're being given the rush.
Not him. Kids are all right until they grow up into men.
I'll be back, if only for my trunks. When it comes to women or horses, Joe, you stick with the horses.
Goodbye, sweetness.
Let's see, we're over here. We'll hop out to the horses. It's Maison Lafitte, just right outside of Paris, three times across the river. We'll step on it. Okay, kid?
Okay.
I'll show you a place that's got more horses than a dog's got fleas.
Hey,
You see, that's how they start off the babies.
Look at him. Will they learn to like it?
Oh, sure. It's in the blood, and what's in the blood don't ever come out. Hey, George!
Danny! Danny Butler, well.
English shock. George Gardner, pretty good.
Well, are you back for good?
When have I been any place for good? My kid, Joe.
All grown up and out of his three-cornered pants, eh?
What are the chances of rustling up some mounts? You know, I could use the money.
Why not? By now, they must have forgotten all about...
Well, as long as they haven't forgotten how I can ride.
Well, I'll be seeing you.
At the cafe?
Sure, every day. Still the same old place.
Right. Be seeing you. Hey, there's just the guy I'm looking for.
Qu'est-ce que vous voyez?
Vidal, Trollur.
Oh, Drake, I got my license. Came this morning.
They sent it up from Italy?
Without a word. Why wouldn't they? How about give me some mounts? I used to do all right for you.
We'll see, Danny.
Say, Pop, when are they going to give us some horses?
The brakes will come.
Going to the races?
Don't we every day? You know, Joe, you gotta have more than horses on the brain. You gotta branch out. How's your French coming?
Great, I guess. Potty's a good teacher.
Say, maybe we ought to go over there this afternoon for another lesson.
Swell. You don't think you're overdoing it, do you, Pop?
No. You need the education. It's good for you. Here's the bus. Come on.
Hello, Joe.
Hello, ma'am.
The first few times you said it was your trunks. Well, you got them.
Well, now it's the kid. Every day, when are we going to see Polly? When are we going to see Polly? Drives me nuts.
I hope it doesn't make you mad, Miss Polly, ma'am.
We can get used to anything.
I wish you'd tell me how you do it, kid. I can't get to the starting post.
Tell you how I do what? Well, I don't do anything. I...
Hey, what do you got a hold of, Joe?
Don't let him tease you. She's very beautiful indeed.
Why don't you go over and show me how it's done?
You mean really go over and speak to her?
Sure.
Well, what would I say?
First time I ever heard you run out of words.
The gentleman would begin. Pardon me, mademoiselle. And then he would wait to see if his attentions were welcome to the lady. Wouldn't a gentleman?
Hmm? Oh, yeah.
If I was to give her a hot tip tomorrow, maybe your mother would let me take her out to the track.
That's great. Go try it, Joe.
You really think I ought to do it?
Well, sure.
Oh, well, she probably doesn't play the horses anyway.
Keep looking for her, Joe. She'll come back. You just keep looking for your girl. You'll find her.
Don't worry, Joe.
You two want me to be alone? Excuse me.
Is he a friend of your father?
No, just a guy I knew in Italy.
Oh.
I'd better go and see Dad.
No, let's talk some French, hmm? That is citron pressé.
Huh?
Citron pressé.
What took you so long?
Where did it all come to, all this stuff of going to Nice and the tickets you bought to South America and later sold? What did he get you, huh? A month of life? Yes, that's something. And paying me back in France instead of Lyon.
You came all the way up here just to tell me that?
No, Danny boy. I'm here on business. Of course, with pleasure as a sideline. Taking care of you will be my pleasure. I always take care of sidelines. I can't forget you, Danny. Every time I look in the mirror, I think of you and how much you owe me.
It didn't hurt your looks. I hear you got ruled off down there. I read where they asked you to move along.
You cost me almost everything I had. You left me holding the sack with the police. You put me on the run, and I don't like being on the run.
You shouldn't try to buy an honest jock, Louis.
Oh, beautiful.
A wise boy like you should know that I'm not kidding when I tell you I think I'm going to kill you, Danny. Just as sure as you're sitting there pretending you're not scared. I'd do it now, like that, without a thought, except I want my money first. I'm funny that way.
Why, hello, Mr. Bork.
Hello, boy.
Ain't you a long ways from home?
Go away, Joe.
Why, if he's still at you about that business
deal. Go pester Polly.
Okay.
A business deal? Is that what you told the kid? In a way, all right. Everything has its price. A double cross has its price.
I'll pay you back. I said I would. Only now you've got to give me a chance. I ain't even been riding.
Riding horses isn't going to get you that kind of money. I'll give you a chance. I'll give you a week. That's next Monday.
What do you mean, a week?
Plenty of time for a smart guy like you to cook up something. Pay up, and then we'll see what more there is to it. I might even let you live a while. I don't know. It depends on how you behave and what kind of mood I am in.
Garçon.
La chaise. La chaise.
La chaise.
La table.
La table.
La porte.
I'll never learn it, Polly.
Polly, I'm beginning to like that Polly.
Oh, so am I.
Coming, won't you?
Right.
Alors, continuons la leçon. La fenêtre.
La fenêtre.
La femme.
La femme.
L'homme.
Pop?
Mais oui, l'homme.
No kidding. Pop, l'homme.
Hop in the cab, kid, and head for home. You're man enough to do it alone. I have some things I want to talk over with Polly.
I got some things, too. She's given me a lesson. Let's stay together, huh?
Like fly on flypaper. Now get going.
Little Joe, do what Papa says.
Now look, kid. Don't be sore with me, huh?
Okay. Some things you think I ain't big enough to get in on.
Ow. How did he know to look for me here? Right here.
Then he is what you ran away from.
What do you mean, ran?
Don't you think I know?
I'm worried about Joe. I'm sick inside with worry.
I can imagine. Well, I'm not interested. Not in him any more than you. I won't be. I've had enough troubles. I'm not going to get myself mixed up again. But if you think you like your kid...
I'm crazy about my kid.
Then do something about it. That farm, in America someplace. Fresh air and milk. Not stables and hotels.
He told you?
Sure, he told me. Do you think it was fun? It was like... Once the day Paris was liberated, I saw a man. I stumbled on the body, ripped open with everything showing. That was just a man. What do you think it's like to see a kid with his heart showing?
I know.
You don't know anything. Why don't you take him home?
Because I can't.
Are you even running out of places to leave?
Yes.
Ne me regarde pas.
Sure. It's easy to say what I ought to do, but he won't go without me. Pup, you can't shake loose from. What's a guy gonna do when he's broken every rule in the books and his kid still thinks he's a 13 apostle?
You find the answer.
I'm always covering for him. Guys with the dirty postcards he doesn't know are dirty postcards. The girls he thinks are being polite. The whole show. It can't last.
Nothing lasts.
I'm running out of lies.
Help me till I can spring him loose for me.
Tell me, how does a man get to be a 100% heel?
It's easy.
What's his name?
Which one, kid?
How can you ask me which one? That one, Pop. He sure looks full of run.
Oh, well, he's the favorite. His name is... His name is King. I'll be right back.
Have you got something in this race, Benny?
No. Give me time.
I give you time. From now until tomorrow. This time.
I'll go into the jock's room and see what's cooking. I guess you want to stay with Paulie, naturally.
Sure, I want to stay with Paulie. But I want to see what's cooking, too.
You better go, Joe, and see what's cooking.
Okay, kid, come on.
Dan.
You go ahead. I'll meet you there.
How bad is it? You'd better tell me.
Lewis? My friend Bork? Well, he says I owe him a lot of money. Quite a fistful. He'll get it or he won't.
And then?
Well, what else could happen? I can handle Lewis.
Are you sure?
Well, maybe. Maybe. George!
Hi, Danny. Hello, Joe.
What's the dope?
I'm riding King.
King? You're sure lucky, George. I never saw such a horse.
Kid, here's 200 francs. Bet it on King, the place, for you and Polly.
The place?
Sure. George is a good jock. He'll be up there. Go on, I'll meet you out front.
Okay.
I wouldn't ask you this, George, but I need a winner bad.
That important, eh?
Buying a slice of life important?
King won't win.
Who will?
Breeze. And if he does, save me a couple of tickets.
Right.
George, dépêche-toi, mon vieux.
Never bet on anything I tell you, Danny.
Hey, kid, climb up on this.
Here, take my glasses.
No, you keep them.
Look at number 8, Joe.
Who?
Number 8, Breeze.
He ain't in it with King.
Good-looking horse, nice quarters.
But he ain't a champ. King's a champ. What's going on, Pop?
Oh, nothing much. They're all bunched up.
Who's in the lead?
Doesn't matter who's in the lead on the back stretch.
Who's King?
Please, Joe.
No thanks, Polly. What's going on, Pop?
Breeze is making his move.
Who?
Breeze, a good horse.
Please, Joe.
No, thanks. Where's King now?
He's still back there loafing along.
Now's no time for him to be doing that.
Here, little Joe, you're dying.
George is waiting a long time. Ain't he waiting a long time?
He's a good jock.
He's waiting too long. He's choking him to death. He's waiting too long. Turn him loose, George. Turn him loose. Turn him loose.
He must have heard you.
I
think he ran out of track, kid. I think it's a breeze.
He really couldn't.
He'd have had it in another stride, but I think he ran out of track. They're going to post the numbers. It's breeze.
It's a crime.
I thought you said George Gardner was a good jock.
He is, kid. He's a great jock. It took a great jock to keep that King horse from winning.
You mean it was a boat race?
The stewards will throw the book at George. Well, you can go and collect your bet. Good thing I told you to play it place. Tell you what I'll do, kid, just to please you. I'll go back and ball George out, and then I'll meet you at the car.
Didn't you bet?
No.
Well, Joe, this betting on the race horses doesn't make sense. We spend 200 francs. We almost die of worry. We do more work, really, than the horse does. And what do we receive? A profit of 40 francs.
It's better than the kick in the pants.
What? What does it mean, kick in the pants?
You can't take it with you, Father.
Well, you can try. I'm going to speak to your father before you die as poor as a rat in a church.
Gee, I would have thought Pop was better than you. Say, Polly.
And even 100 for 10, right?
No.
Do send me.
Oh, we were told to go to the car.
200,000. C'était à Paris première.
Oh, oui. Luckiest bet I ever made in my life. That breeze came through. Good horse.
You lied to me.
Come on, let's go.
You said you didn't bet. You lied to me.
Come on, let's
you
go.
You knew it was a crooked race because George told you. You lied and bet on it. And that makes you no better than a crook.
Don't be a snot and stay out of my business.
You're a crook! A crook! A crook!
Joe. You beast.
You stay out, too.
I am out.
Polly! Polly! I'll eat you! I'll run away! Polly!
You won't run away.
I'm gonna fall.
You'll do what I tell you. Now, come on.
Dad, I've said I'm sorry 100 times.
Sorry? What's sorry? The boat sailed and yours is going to. Now, come on. Let's get going.
But you said it's on the fritz over there.
Now it's on the fritz here.
I remember when you bought me those shirts. Down in Rome, after you copped a big one. You got them big because you said I was growing like a stinkweed. Don't you even want to remember the good things?
I'm sick and tired of having you in my hair, and I'll get going. Come on. She'll want you, all right. All women like kids, and all kids belong with women. Haven't I done everything I could? I got you your tickets. I gave you a letter to show you every step of the way. I've got guys to help you all along. I gave you most of my money, and if that runs out, I'll get you more. You won't be a burden on anyone. Now, stop your belly aching and get on the train. It's going to start to move. Come on.
kid.
Don't send me away, Dad. Don't make me go. Please, Bob. Please don't make me go.
Joe, Joe. It's for the best.
Tu me vois ce soir. Le ciel est rempli d'étoiles. Comme pendant la nuit où tu m'avais promis ton amour pour la vie. Viendras-tu me voir ce soir?
Hi, sweetness.
Toi qui me poursuis sans cesse, je voulais t'oublier, oublier tes promesses, oublier ma folie. Mais c'est en vain car le destin t'a placé sur mon chemin. Ce destin qui, bien malgré moi, me fait demander chaque fois. Viendras-tu me voir ce soir, avant que le jour se lève, avant que mon beau rêve.
Mais au moins tu m'offres une consommation.
Et oui. Que tout soit fini.
Quelque chose ce soir, hein?
Je ne peux plus vivre sans toi. Tu sais bien que je t'aime. N'as-tu pas compris à ma voix combien lourde est ma peine?
Mais qu'est-ce que tu as? Tu as l'air triste, toi.
Viendras-tu me voir ce soir, avant que le jour se lève, avant que mon beau rêve s'efface dans la nuit, et que tout soit fini.
Are you sick? You got hurt?
No. I'm in great shape. I just came around and looked the dump over. I got my fill and now I'm going. Hey, you know, that was a pretty good number you did. You really know how to sell it. La 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 la, ce soir. La 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 la, fini.
You're nuts, Steak. You're drunk.
La 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 la,
you're filthy drunk.
Soir.
And I came running after you.
I figured you would. You're right, I'm sick. I've been to the doctor. He told me I've got everything. I got TB and cancer, and I've got you.
You're crazy.
No. No. I haven't got you. Let me look at what I haven't got.
I'm sorry, Dan. If I hurt you this afternoon, I'm sorry, but you and your kid has done nothing but tell you the truth. Little Joe...
Keep his name out of it, understand? He's none of your business. He's none of anybody's business.
You're really sick, Dan. Come upstairs. I'll take care of you. I'll do anything if you need me.
Why lower your standards? You've been used to dealing with pretty high-class heels all your life. You told me so.
Please, Dan, come on.
Everything's got a price. Double cross, a slice of life, a toothbrush, a dame. You pay for what you get. Yeah. I haven't gotten much left. I spent the rest on a spree. Pay.
Why did you do that?
Morning, Dan. Who are you writing?
Gilford.
Oh, good luck.
I'll need it.
Sick this morning, Dan?
No, I'm okay.
Where's your boy?
Today, he's okay, too.
That's the meanest horse ever born.
How would you like to get rid of me?
Why, what do you mean?
If I can't get any mounts, I'll buy one. How much?
Well, if you're not joking, you can have him for his feed bill. And I'll throw in the saddle.
You've made yourself a sale, my friend. Now I'll show you how to handle that animal.
A boat race. I was all wrong. You just didn't like the odds on King and you picked a long shot breeze. And you're a gambler, Pop, a great gambler. And you just fell into a pot full of luck. Here, it's all yours. It ain't mine.
But how did you...
He got off the train, Dan. He came back.
Alley cat, a guy can't get rid of. For years, I've been drumming up enough courage to send you back home where you belong. Now you come floating back. Like you're running the show. Ought to break your neck. Come here.
Gee, Pop, I was scared you'd be sore. But you ain't sore, huh? Hey, Polly, you ain't mad. I like to run with you, Pop. Just like old times. Sweating plenty, Pop?
Hey, kid. I got a surprise for you. I'm pooped.
What you are, you're soft like jelly.
What are we training for? We got a horse we can't get out of a stall with a derrick.
I got a notion about Gilford, Dad.
What ain't you got? You're full of notions as a bargain basement.
We're owners. Just 1 week and we'll get our owner's papers. Of course, we ain't got our colors yet.
You got a notion about that?
Red, white, and blue.
What?
Red, white, and blue. French colors, Pop.
Yeah, sure. What's your notion about the horse?
The way I figure, it's not just his muscles that need training. It's his character that needs working on.
Like me, huh?
No, Pop, don't get me wrong.
Well, go on about the horse.
Something you showed me once. The baby's in the ring. Maybe he hasn't been happy since he was a young one. Maybe that's what's wrong with him. Maybe he wants to jump. Maybe he's a jumper.
Say.
up, boy. Come on.
You know, a trainer once told me if you got a mean or a nervous horse, put him in a jumping ring, and 9 times out of 10, like that.
Up, boy. Higher, boy.
Tout le monde reprend en chœur.
La scène est aventureuse, le Châtillon a mairi, et son humeur voyageuse flâne à travers le pays. Elle se fait la greuse, le Juvisy a choisi. Pour aborder l'amoureuse, l'amour qu'elle a choisi. Elle recoule, la coule, la coule, dès qu'elle entre dans Paris. Elle s'enroule, roule, roule, autour de ses quais fleuris. Elle chante, 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 chante. Le jour et la nuit, car la Seine est une amante, et son amant, c'est Paris. Elle traîne d'île en île, caressant le vieux Paris. Elle ouvre ses bras dociles au sourire du roi Henri, indifférente aux édiles de la mairie de Paris. Elle court vers les idylles des amants des Tuileries. Elle roule, coule, coule, coule du Pont d'Arc jusqu'à Passy. Elle est saoule, saoule, saoule au souvenir de Bercy.
I know you. You're Danny's friend. Nice boy. He has good taste. He isn't here for a night.
No, I'm not expecting him.
No, I don't imagine he's much of a night bird now, but still, he could be celebrating, couldn't he? You saw this, I suppose. Gilford Favoris du Grand Prix. Yes, it looks as if our Danny's in. I am in. We all are in.
Just what do you mean, we all are in?
Of course, you know, Danny and I, we've had our little difference. Small matter of money. He's been paying now and then, little installment. But now with this, it looks as if he may end his troubles. The horse will do it. To the horse. To Gilford.
To Dan. I think it's about time he got a break. He told me he was indebted to you. He told me several times and he was worried about it.
Well, so was I. Ah, but that's all past. Behind us. With a horse like Gilford, men can get along. They should. I've waited. As a matter of fact, I've been extremely patient. Good Danny. Everybody's favorite. Well, my dear, if you will excuse me, I must go take care of my sideline for tonight. I always take care of sidelines. Ask Danny. Mademoiselle.
Hello.
75 kilos.
I don't know, darling. I just got him from Paris. I suppose he's still at the stables.
We gotta find him. You don't expect Gilford to carry?
No.
75 kilos. We gotta tell him.
Come on.
You want a tip? Ask the guy in the street. Everybody knows how's the horse.
You think he'll win?
Well, I know he'll win.
Good. Now I've got a surprise for you. He's going to lose.
What's the angle? Don't tell me you think you can put the fix on up here in France.
No. The fix isn't on the race, Danny. It's on you. You see, I'm booking every bet I can against you. It's a fortune.
I could pay up even with the purse.
I'm not interested in just even. Set something up, you told me, in Italy, and it won't go wrong. I'm setting it up.
Nothing doing. Nothing doing. Nothing doing in general and nothing doing in particular.
Italian gloves. Oh, good leather. Handy. I told you, Danny, that when the cash account was square, I'd let you know what more there would be to it, depending on my mood. Ah! I'm in a good mood, Danny. You're in luck. Throw it.
Ah!
I said, throw it, Danny. Throw this for me tomorrow and you're a free man. Clear of me. For old time's sake. What's just one more boat race?
How can I believe you?
Who cares? But you can believe this. If you don't lose, you'll never live to crawl into your bed tomorrow night.
Hey, Pa!
The kid.
Hey, Patrick.
Let me loose.
All right. You fooled that kid for years. You can do it for one more day. Or do you want me to have a talk with him?
Looking for me?
Dad, there were 75 kilos on it.
Hello, boy. Good luck tomorrow. The horse looks great.
What were you saying?
Nothing.
What's on your mind?
Gilford's got to carry 75 kilos.
He can win with 100. Now go fix his blanket.
Are you going to...
Am I going to what?
It would kill you.
Stop telling me how to live, will you?
More coffee?
Huh? No. Thanks. I'll go for a walk, I guess.
Alone?
Why not?
Dan, what do they want you to do? Throw the race?
What do you think?
Are you going to?
Don't worry, I'll win by a mile, if I can.
And what would Bork do?
He'll kill me if he can catch me.
But darling, you're crazy.
Yeah?
It's just this one race he wants?
That's what he says.
Then lose it. Pay him back. Get rid of them once and for all.
That's funny coming from you after that crack you made this afternoon in the stables. It would kill Joe.
But it's just one more race.
Just one more. One more and one more. And that's the way it goes. When I was 15, I threw my first one. I've thrown hundreds since. Now look at me. The places I run away from, the places I can't show my face. A guy winds up playing tag with himself. He's got to stop sometime.
But only after this one.
But this one isn't mine. It belongs to Joe. It belongs to the kid. He made it. It's his horse. Nobody else in the world could have thought of making that horse into a jumper but Joe. The least I owe him is an honest ride.
But Dan, you can this time, I beg you. You can take the chance.
Look, honey, a guy winds up with whatever he's got and no more. I'm not talking about money. Any bird with $1 million can be a millionaire. But now me, I'm one of the poorest guys on earth, but I got something. I got the love for my kid. The rest I spent on the way, but I still got that.
Yes, Dad.
And I love you, too. Funny kind of setup we walked into. Me going for you, you going for the kid. Kid going for me.
I love you with everything.
Yeah? I'm a fine guy to love. You're running true to form.
You still want to take that walk?
Why not?
Alone?
No. Don't worry, honey. We'll find a place. There just has to be another place.
Twice over the river jump.
That's far enough.
Sleep last night?
Oh, like a top. You?
I didn't. Look, Dan, you won't win. Bork will have somebody in there just to put you down.
How do you know?
He offered me the job.
How could you resist? George, I want you to collect the purse money for me. Here's a letter to the stewards.
Bork will kill you.
Maybe. With the purse money and all I win on myself, I want you to help Polly get my kid back to the States. Maybe she'll go along. I hope so.
Dan, my horse won't win. But he's got a good turn of speed up front. So I'll ride alongside of you as long as I can and see what I can do to help.
Thanks. Just long enough for me to spot Borg's monkey.
That's it. I'd give a lot to know who Louie's boy is.
Say, you wouldn't cross me and try to win, would you?
I might.
Hey, Pop! I never saw Gilford look so good. He just looks great.
Come on.
On tire bien, hein? Allons, les gars, mettez-vous en ligne. Hé, les gars, allons, en ligne.
Anybody can see he's trying to win. Now he's trying to kill him.
If he don't, I will.
Too much to ask of him to make up that much ground.
It's a cinch now, eh, boss?
Why doesn't he quit?
Quit! The old man, quit! Give it to him, Pop!
après le petit.
Come, Joe.
Une ambulance tout de suite.
Pop, you feel okay?
I guess we made it, huh?
We sure did, Pop.
Well, that's all that counts. Just another race.
Why did you do it, Dad?
Well, this one, I had to win. Maybe now we'll go home together, huh?
Yes, Dan, I promise.
Pop! Maybe it's for...
The greatest race I ever saw. He died winning it honest. They can't ever take that away from him. He was a great jockey.
Well, they put his name on the roll of honor.
They can't keep it off. He was a great jockey and a great guy.
Sure. He was my own man.